quick inspection underneath. So I have to double check which way this machine turns, but the reason it's called a rotary is because it has one of the early rotary bobbin hooks that only travels one direction. So that, I believe, is the white sewing machine edge. They had a rotary bobbin when everybody else had to do shuttles, or rotary hook when everybody else had to do shuttles. But I do see there is a bit of thread stuck in here, right here. So we'll have to pull this out and get a look at it. The machine did come with the manual, and I read the manual. The first half of the manual is instructions. The second half is actually a sewing tutorial book. But for cleaning, it recommends using kerosene or lamp oil to rub the machine off and then oil it. So I will not be doing that, but I am going to be dusting and wiping this down before I oil it again. And also, actually, that is a quick release for the hook race. Look at that. There, just have to make sure that it's in the right spot. So, there's the hook and the race, and all of the thread jammed in on this hook. Oh my gosh, so much. Well, I guarantee the machine wasn't stitching properly with all that thread jammed in on the hook race. So we'll get back to this with better cleaning. I'm also going to have to look and see, double check the needle sizes for it, because it does have a diagram in the book, and these older machines may not use standard needles. So I got to double check that and see whether a standard needle will work in this machine. Alright, one more thing about this machine. It's still on its back. Cleaned all this lint out of here. And there is an arrow on the hook race driver here. I'm going to have to get a needle or a pin and double check that these drivers are really clean, because there looks like there might be a space behind them. But there's an arrow for the rotation direction, and that is backwards. Modern machines, the standard rotation is to roll the hand wheel forward, grab it on top, and pull it toward you. This machine, I'm grabbing on top and pulling it forward me, and it's running backwards. So this machine runs where you push the hand wheel away from you, which is backwards from most modern machines. All right. The wiring on this machine is 1930s-ish, wrapped, fabric wrapped, but it looks like it's kinda in decent shape, so I'm gonna test it quick. I got this machine plugged in. Yep. And this is a rubber drive tire that's pretty hard, because I don't know how old that is, but the machine does, like I said, rotate backwards from normal. And we'll have to rewire that, because the wiring on it just isn't safe anymore. And we'll see if we can find a drive tire for it. Yeah, so I got this unplugged again, but it's got a nice three-prong socket. But this is all cloth insulated wire, which means that the tar used to provide the real insulation is about 100 years old now, getting dry and crumbly. Every time you touch it, more tar works out of it, and also there's fraying. So we'll have to replace all that. The drive tire is rock hard, so we'll see if they make drive tires like this anymore. If not, I have some ideas for what can get put on there to fix it up, but we'll start and see if there are easy replacements. We'll explore this wiring as we go. This is going to be an interesting cabinet to work on because I have not done a lot of these luxury fold-up cabinets like this since they lost popularity in the 60s and 70s. All right. Here's the wire for the light in a beautiful insulated holder. I have to get a shorter screw driver to reach up under here and get this screw to pop the light out. But we'll take the wiring apart and rewire it right away. We'll have to rewire it, but I can test it before I rewire it, make sure that I get it stitching. Once I think it's stitching, we'll go with rewiring it. This machine seems like it's actually in very good shape, despite how old it is. So the main thing will be wiping it off real good, because it's definitely dusty and collected grime in the roughly 100 years it's been around. And I might find a better date for it, because the instruction book does not have a date in it. Aside from including a note that the founder of the company died in 1914. But this is an electric machine, so it's definitely, it's probably from the 30s or 40s. Well, 30s, my guess is. I think by the 40s they had a different style. But electric machines didn't really become widespread until the 30s because that's when home electrification got real big in the United States.